Scaffolding means building the structure along the process of learning so that students can meet the learning goals. Scaffolding is a necessary and caring practice in setting students up to get to those goals. It is essential that what you are asking students to practice and demonstrate is aligned with those goals and the mode of assessment. You also want that process to be supported. Scaffolding can be done in any number of ways. Some have to do with tapping into CUNY and campus resources. Others are practices in the classroom that can help support learning. Here are a few examples of scaffolding. 1. Before asking students to embark on a high-stakes research assignment, you can do a diagnostic assessment of their proficiency with research tools and methods. 2. Coordinate with the college library for an informational literacy session. 3. Provide tools and resources for doing research such as OwlPurdue and citation machines. 4. Offer in-class workshops where students could do parts of their projects during class time. This could be a great way to practice and engage with relevant skills and knowledge in a low-stakes environment. And provide formative feedback. You can also use small group or peer review if appropriate. 5. Another scaffolding practice is to check in with the Writing Center at your campus to see if they could provide tutoring services or writing support to your students. 6. Locate and share digital resources such as tutorials and lectures that can help students with aspects of their projects. Short videos that show students how to do something or explain a concept can be very helpful tools to support your students. 7. Offer office hours, either in person or virtual, to check in with students about their projects or assignments. If individual check-ins are unrealistic, you can consider doing small group check-ins. 8. Staggering deadlines for milestones in an assignment can also help students move through the assignment. Don't just set a due date for a big assignment. Provide steps, benchmarks, or a timeline to help students move through that work. You can scaffold most assignments and engage different practices and resources to do so. You may scaffold the take-home exam by asking students to be in a reading group and discussion activity during class review. You may scaffold doing a lab report by having students do a practice run in class and respond to your feedback first. There are many tools and methods and resources that can be used to scaffold many types of assignments. Using library resources, particularly informational literacy sessions offered at many campuses, can be a powerful way to scaffold so many research-based assignments. Providing students with links to places where they can get their citations done and other tools that can help with their assignments is another practice in scaffolding. Finally, building time in the class and offering a space to ask questions, practice skills, and check in with students is really beneficial to support the learning that is happening during the course of the assignment. Another major benefit to scaffolding is that it minimizes any confusion or opportunity for plagiarism. An assignment doesn't have to be a siloed activity within the context of the course. Rather, it's an opportunity to engage, practice, collaborate, workshop, explore, and provide meaningful feedback.